Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel Easy Mathematics. Today we are going to discuss about the Kuratowski's graph. In our last video lecture we discussed about the planar graph, and Kuratowski's graph is one of the most important graph which requires in the planar graph. So what is Kuratowski's graph? A complete graph with 5 vertices is called Kuratowski's first graph. In fact, there are 2 type of Kuratowski's graph. Kuratowski's first graph is the complete graph with 5 vertices, that is K5. And this one is its picture. So here the 5 vertices are given and it is a complete graph because all the vertices having degree 4. Now Kuratowski's second graph is what? A regular graph with 6 vertices and 9 edges is called Kuratowski's second graph, and it is denoted by K33. K33 means we know it is a complete bipartite graph with 3 and 3 vertices, that means total 6 vertices, and both the sides there are total 3 vertices. So this is the picture of the K33 graph. This is the Kuratowski's second graph. So both the graphs are very much known to us. First one is the complete graph with 5 vertices, and the second one is the complete bipartite graph with the 6 vertices. So why these two graphs are that much important in the planar graph? For that, at first we come to know about the few important things about the Kuratowski's graph. So the first is K5 and K33 are connected non-planar graphs. It is very obvious both are the connected and the non-planar graph. How it is non-planar, that we will understand just later on. Now K5 and K33 are regular graph. Obviously both the graph having the same degree count for each and every vertex. Here all the vertices having degree 4 and here all the vertices having degree 3. So both the graphs, we should say that these are the regular graphs. Now K5 is a non-planar graph with smallest number of vertices. K5 is having a speciality that K5 is the smallest number of vertices. The K5, the graph having the smallest number of vertices, for which we can say a graph is non-planar. Likewise, K33 is a non-planar graph with smallest number of edges. In K33, the smallest number of edges are there for a non-planar graph. So in K5, here we have total the 5 vertices, and in K33 there are total 9 edges. So a graph for being a non-planar, there definitely be minimum 5 number of vertices are there, and for the edge regarding there minimum 9 number of edges are there, then we can have the conclusion that the graph is non-planar. Now one more thing, that is deletion of a vertex or an edge makes K5 and K33 a non-planar. If we delete any one vertex or any one edge from both these two graphs, K5 and K33, then these graphs becomes the planar graph. Now there is a Kuratowski's theorem. So what is the statement for this theorem? A graph is planar if and only if it does not contain K5 or K33 as a subgraph. In other words, a graph is planar if and only if it has no subgraph homeomorphic to K5 or K33. We know what is homeomorphic graphs. So Kuratowski's theorem is what? That if any graph will not contain K5 or K33 as its subgraph, then we can say that the given graph is a planar graph. Otherwise, it is a non-planar graph. Now, corresponding to that, we should prove that if from the K5 we delete one vertex, then it becomes a planar graph. So, we should show that K5 from, if we delete any one vertex, then it becomes a planar graph. So initially this one is our K5. From here, if we delete any one vertex, so suppose we delete this vertex. So if we delete this vertex, then its incidenting edge is also deleted. So after that deletion, our reduced graph becomes this one. So here we will find out that in K5, n is equals to 5. Number of edges, we know that it is a complete graph. So number of edges are n into n minus 1 by 2. So that is 10. And in the reduced graph, it is n is equals to 4. And this reduced graph is also a complete graph. So its total number of edges are 6. since K5 minus B, that means the reduced graph, which is a K4, that is the complete graph with 4 vertices, which contains a circuit of length 3. Just look here, if we consider this one as the circuit, then this one having the length 3. So, we should apply the third theorem for the planar graph, which we discussed in our previous video. So, according to that theorem, we know that E should be less than equals to 3n minus 6. If we substitute the value of n and E in this equation, then it will provide us 6 is less than equals to 6. So, which is true? Hence, Kuratowski's first graph is planar if one vertex is removed from that graph. If we remove one vertex, then this graph becomes the planar graph. Otherwise, this is a non-planar graph. The next one, if we remove one edge from the Kuratowski's first graph, then what happens? If we remove any one edge, suppose this one is the edge which we should remove. After removal of that edge, our reduced graph becomes this one. So, just like the previous, in K5, the total number of vertices are 5, total number of edges are 10. And in the reduced graph, that means K5 minus E, number of vertices remains unchanged, that is 5. And the number of edges are 1 less than the previous one, that is 9. So, according to the theorem 3, that is E less than equals to 3N minus 6, if we substitute the value of E and N here, then we will find out here E is 9. And 3 into 5 minus 6 is equals to 9, which is again true. Hence, Kuratowski's first graph is planar if we remove one edge from the graph. So, any one edge if we remove from this graph, then it still remains the planar graph. Otherwise, it is a non-planar graph. Likewise, if it is the Kuratowski's second graph. So, Kuratowski's second graph, if we have and from there, if we remove one vertex, then what happens? This is the Kuratowski's second graph. And if we remove any one vertex, suppose this vertex we should remove. This one is our vertex V, and if we remove this one, then we will find out this one as the reduced graph. And in K3-3, the total number of vertices is 6 and the total number of edges it is 3 cross 3, because we know in the bipartite graph, the total number of edges are N in N cross M. So, here N is 3, M is also 3, so it is 9. If we remove one vertex from here, then its incidenting edge is also removed from here. So, after removal of this one, the total number of vertices becomes 5. And just look, this graph having the 2 vertex in one side and 3 vertex in another side, and it is also a complete bipartite graph with 5 vertices. One side having 2 vertices, another side having 3 vertices. So, the total number of edges are 2 cross 3 means 6. So, the edge number is 6 here. So, now observe this one. As it is the complete bipartite graph, or it is a bipartite graph, then here the any circuit which will form having the even number of edges. If we start from this point, then this one to this one, then this point to this point, this point to this point, and this point to this point. If we move, then it is a circuit. And it contains 4 edges. In fact, whatever be the circuit you form, these are the even in number. So, accordingly, we should say that since this reduced graph does not contain any circuit of length 3, therefore, from the theorem E less equals to 2n minus 4, which is the fourth theorem for the planar graph, which is discussed in our previous video. So, from there we get, after substitution of the value of E and N, it is 6, which is true. That means 6 is less equals to 6, which is true. Hence, Kuratowski's second graph is planar if one vertex is removed from the graph. Similarly, one more proof is required here. That is, if from the Kuratowski's second graph, we remove any one edge, then what happens? Let this one is the edge which we should remove. After removal of this edge, we will find out this one as the reduced graph. So, in previously, K3-3 have 6 vertices and 9 edges. And in the reduced graph, the number of vertices remains same, that is 6. And the number of edges 1 less than the previous one, that is 8. Since K3-3 minus E, that means the reduced graph, does not contain any circuit of length 3. Therefore, from the fourth theorem for the planar graph, we will have e less equals to 2n minus 4. So we get from there, if we substitute the value of e and n respectively, e is 8 and n is 6, then we will find out 8 is less equals to 8, which is true. Hence, Kuratowski's second graph is planar, and removal of one edge from the graph makes it planar. So hence, all these things which we can say about the Kuratowski's graph, which are the very much important in the further application and the discussion of the planar graph. So in this video, that's all. Thank you.